And here with reaction to all of this is the co-author of The Post-American Presidency and the director of JihadWatch.org, Robert Spencer, and the president of the World Muslim Congress, Michael Gauss, is back with us. Good to see you. When you put all of this together for me, this seems to me not only like a guy who we shouldn't be paying for his trip to the Middle East as a representative of the United States, sounds to me like somebody who ought to be investigated.
Oh, absolutely, Sean. This guy, look, everybody should just read his book, What's Right with Islam. So there you go, Faisal Abdul Rauf, I'm plugging your book. But the reality is that in his book, he openly calls for Islamic law. He defends it. He never rules out the aspects of it that restrict the freedom of speech. As a matter of fact, he calls for free speech restrictions in the U.S. And I think that that is enlightening in itself, in light of all the abuse that he's heaped on people who oppose this mega mosque at Ground Zero. You know, we're holding another rally on 9/11 against the mosque, and we're doing it because we believe in American principles, and he clearly denies those principles and clearly is in favor of a draconian form of Islamic law.
Michael, is there anything here that you know, not condemning Hamas, anything that bothers you about this imam?
Well, I think Imam Faisal Rauf said something very interesting. He's a bridge builder. As Americans, we need to think about it.
Forget the bridge building stuff. I'm not interested in that. I mean, what about, is America an accessory to 9/11, Michael?
Absolutely not.
Is Osama bin Laden made in the USA?
Well, I think our policies, we encourage the Taliban. We created Taliban in Afghanistan to fight against the Soviets. In fact, I believe President Reagan
So, Michael, do you think there should be Sharia in the United States? Do you think there should be restrictions on the freedom of speech?
Well, first of all, let me acknowledge a few things. It's so good for Fox News as a service to the United States.
No, I just asked a question.
Michael, we don't have a lot of time. Answer his question.
What is it, Robert?
It was a very simple question. Do you believe, along with Faisal Abdul Rauf, that there should be restrictions on freedom of speech and Sharia, Islamic law, in the United States with the stonings and the amputations and the oppression of women and the warfare against unbelievers?
First of all, freedom of speech is the most honorable things. No
restrictions. So you disagree with Faisal Abdul Rauf?
I did not agree with him.
Great.
Freedom of speech must be honored. And again, Sharia law, Robert, you know you are an expert.
And you denounce Hamas as a terrorist group.
I'm sorry?
And you denounce Hamas as a terrorist group then as well?
Hamas is a terrorist group, absolutely, for what they have said. But again,
so how can you support this imam?
What he is doing is building bridges. We as
lying?
United States. No, he's not lying.
Well, wait a minute. I'm confused then. Because if he's for Hamas and he's against freedom of speech and he's for Sharia and you're against all those things that he's for and you're for all those things that he's against and yet you support him, it just doesn't add up.
Robert, he is not for Hamas. What he is,
he wouldn't condemn Hamas.
Judgment. Yeah, that's fine.
Why?
That's his choice.
Why?
His choice. He's got the freedom
Hamas
to say.
Hamas blows people up in restaurants and on buses. And how could any decent person support a group like that or refuse to condemn a group like that?
Absolutely. Because if he also condemns Hamas, he will lose the ability to negotiate with the terrorists.
Oh,
and
so he has to
peace.
Appease the terrorist.
It's not the question of appeasing, Robert. It is the question of understanding and dealing with them. You cannot deal with people if you accuse them, if you tell them wrong things.
You can't negotiate with terrorists, Michael.
You got it. So he can't negotiate with terrorists. So he's got to be nice to them.
If you push the terrorists to the corner, they don't have many options.
Yeah, I don't want to give them any options at all.
I want them
to stop doing what they're doing. And I support people who do anything in their power to neutralize the terrorists.
Robert, your policies have not worked in 50 years, and they will not work. We need to work a new policy of relating
with
people.
This is the problem of dishonesty and dissimulation that we have with all these
spokesmen. Now, tomorrow night, we're going to have a special report on this imam. I won't tell you about it now, but we've done some investigative work, and we will tell you about that tomorrow. Thank you for being with us. Appreciate it.